Hello. Thanks for joining me outside the frame. I'm Mary Murray, curator of modern and contemporary art. Today we're looking at a painting by Ida Applebroog, who was born in the Bronx in 1929. She has lived around the country but returned to New York City in the 1970s and was an important artist in that second wave of feminism to address issues that were crucial to women's lives. Her primary subject is power relationships between women, between parents and children, doctors and their patients, government leaders and citizens. She uses a comic book kind of style to address very serious issues, issues such as child abuse or rape. And she describes herself as an image scavenger. She takes pictures from tabloids and other print media to rearrange in a fragmented kind of composition. And she very specifically uses fragmentation as part of her content to convey a sense of fragmentation or disruption in contemporary life. In this particular image, the title is Circumcise, Ostracize. And right from the beginning, we understand that there aren't easy answers about this painting. And this is very typical of Applebroog's work. The viewer is invited to participate in creating meaning. She's not telling us by any stretch what this work is about, starting from the title. So you can use those words as perhaps an entree. If they don't mean anything to you, what do the pictures mean? We have two main panels, a cake that says, "Good luck, Mr. Henry," and a very strange image of an older man holding a girl, and she has a bucket on her head. Around the periphery, what might be called marginalia, pictures around the edge, we see a device that she uses frequently, and that is the repeated image. It is as if these are individual cells of a film, and this will create movement, which is very helpful when we look at the swimmer, or it gives a sense of continuity from one image to the next. So how do we begin to put together meaning in this picture? We do see a picture of a man's coat and a woman's dress hanging on hangers. So perhaps they will stand in for as symbols for relations between a man and a woman. The swimmer is an athlete, someone who's escaping. And what of the people who were walking in what looks like pajamas and they have shaved heads? Applebroog herself has ideas about what this picture might mean. She says, for instance, that maybe Mr. Henry was a cancer patient and this is a cake that the nurses made for him when he was released from the hospital. And maybe those people in pajamas are cancer patients. They also, to my eye, look like they could be concentration camp prisoners. The man licking the knife is kind of a creepy, dangerous thing to do. Even if it's in this cartoon kind of style, we see, well, maybe it's not so bad if he's cutting cake and it's a family gathering, but the family gathering maybe is not so pleasant because this man is embracing a little girl with a bucket on her head. The bucket may be symbolic or metaphorical, a way that this child is trying to keep herself protected by armoring herself from unwanted advances. That's my reading of it. But it's interesting because a man about my age looked at it and he identified with the man doing the hugging. So he identified with that figure as trying to express in an inappropriate way feelings that he's never been taught how to express, which was fascinating to me because I saw that figure as being threatening. I felt vulnerable like the little girl. And finally, what about the face on the edge looking in Some people read it as Mao Zedong, the father of the Chinese Communist Revolution. I myself have always thought of it as being Archie Bunker in the armchair of his queen's home. In any case, he is looking from the side into the subject of this particular artwork that we ourselves are scratching our heads over, looking on as well, trying to understand the difficulty that Ida Applebroog is trying to express to us. Applebroog's paintings can be very difficult to look at. She understands that the subject matter can cause people to recoil from them, but she feels compelled to tell these stories in her own way. Like the fragmentation of the imagery, she also uses her paint medium to convey a certain quality about the story. In this particular painting, the colors are muted pink and brown or sepia, so they have a quality of being outside of our regular experience, almost like a photograph from decades before, maybe something from our memory. And she also uses gel medium to dilute the pigment, and that gives it less a buttery quality and more like a, I don't know, larded quality that isn't necessarily a pleasant sensation. I'm Mary Murray. Thank you for joining me outside the frame with Ida Applebroog.